Nothing specifically, just like the usual, like clothes, snacks.
Very boring.
Maybe
actually.
Like a laptop or something. Mm-hmm. Bored.
Now a PS4.
Actually. Oh yes.
Now that I have one, a PS4.
It's like a soft toy sloth, but it's just like a really good pillow. I think it is a pillow. I bought it in India, and it's just it makes every plane journey like so much more comfortable. So Terence the sloth comes with me everywhere.
Yeah, I tend to take my PS4 at the minute. Just there's a lot of downtime, so I need to keep myself entertained.
I don't really take anything, to be honest. There's nothing like this an absolute ritual that I must have in my bag. I just take the usual stuff. I'm quite boring, to be honest. Make sure I've got a good book with me, but that's kind of it. Sold.
No sloth pillow then?
No, I'm not got a sloth pillow. I've not got a PS4. I'm so boring.
Yeah. We've visited there twice this year, and it was nice to like see around in the centre. And I think there's this coffee place we went to quite a lot.
Shout out to etc.
Yeah.
I think I'd say Singapore for me. I think Singapore just because it was new and it was green, and yeah, it's pretty cool.
Ooh, I think it was really nice to be back in Bangkok this year. My God, it was hot, but it's just really it's a nice atmosphere. It's all buzzy and busy, and it's just such a nice mixture of good food, good coffee. The people are really nice.
I quite enjoy Indonesia. We don't necessarily get out to see a massive amount of it, but the setup with the hall and the hotel and the malls round about it is quite comfortable, and we feel quite at home.
For me, I always enjoy playing in All England down in Birmingham. I think it's always really nice to actually play near home. You only have to drive or get a train down. You don't have to fly for 95 million hours. So it's actually quite nice just to get a nice short journey. My parents can come watch. You're feeling more relaxed in a kind of more normal environment. So yeah, I mean, I'm going to say Birmingham really left field.
Chicken pop.
What's chicken pop?
It's just like Alex, every day we were in Malaysia, Alex, we went to this place, etc. And he just,
it's
chicken pot.
It's
got to be beef ragu and with some garlic bread.
What about chicken pops?
Oh, no. That was only in that 4 weeks there. It was all I had.
He's waiting popcorn chicken, I think, for the 4 weeks. A good pasta is nice after a meal. You know, good amount of carbs, a good garlic bread. It's hard to find a good garlic bread when you find it.
Favorite post-match meal. If it's in Bangkok, mango sticky rice. But in general, I think I probably crave like a cheeky pizza after like a good tournament win. I'll maybe like treat myself to a good pizza at the end. I have been craving like a proper fish and chips, so like maybe that's on the card soon.
Not really, maybe it's just something upbeat.
Mine changes quite a lot. So right now it's like More Than a Woman by the Bee Gees. Don't know why.
Right, and I was told earlier that you would sing as a bit of a...
No, I can't. More Than a Woman. No.
Give us a verse.
That's all you're getting.
I'm not a mad music listener pre-match. I like to kind of have thoughts and I can't concentrate with music on. So I'm more of a quiet time pre-match person.
Again, I'm really boring. I don't really listen to music.
I don't have one particular, just whatever's in my most recent like songs on my Spotify, I'll put them on and hope for the best.
Can you give us a tune now?
Oh God, don't know what my recent likes are. Sorry.
I also want to clarify, I don't not listen to music, just not before training or matches. I do listen to music.
Maybe some country music, actually, country to be honest. I do enjoy a bit of country. It's not,
country.
Not too hype.
Group that we've kind of cultivated over the years within Scotland and within like kind of the European players is a really nice chance for us to just spend some time with our like international friends, but also the food. That's one of the highlights of traveling for me, just like trying all the food.
My favorite thing is meeting people from different countries. I think we've become quite close friends to a few of the players from the different countries, so it's quite nice seeing them when we're away. Mm. So
yeah, I think that, and I think like getting to see new cultures and like experiencing new food and stuff is always pretty cool. Getting to explore places that like you wouldn't usually get to go and see.
I don't know, being on the road is not my most enjoyable part of being a band player, to be honest. I miss my dog very much when I'm not at home. But if I had to pick something, it's more the people that we see on the tour. Like, we're good friends with quite a lot of the guys in Europe and around the world, so it's nice to see them more than anything else. But actually being on the road is not really a very much highlight for me.
I guess, I think a lot of the band team enjoy coffee. There's some crazy amount of good coffee shops like across the world, and to get to see them is quite interesting. It breaks up the part of your training and your competition. It's quite nice to get out and see some of that.
Yes, I've become quite obsessed with Outlander recently. It's just very Scottish.
Yeah.
I like it. It's like a little bit of home whilst I'm away. But podcasts, I listen to Armchair Expert with Dax Shepherd and Monica Padman a lot. It's just quite a good mix of like celebrity guests, experts, and like phone-in answers and stuff. That's a good time. And music, it's the classic rotation of Muna, Paramore, Haim, Paris, Fickle Friends, that kind of genre.
Mine is a podcast called Nearly Weds. It's about two people that are getting married. It's so funny. I recommend everyone to give it a listen.
There must be something. I mean, that's quite normal, but if anyone's not seen Schitt's Creek yet, I'd watch Schitt's Creek. It's a very, very good show, hilarious, and yeah, it's an easy watch.
Bit of a dark one, but Midnight Mass. Great series. Don't watch it if you're a child because it's scary.
Just one.
Gossip Girl.
I don't know.
Friends.